always good to start on time, but when you don't have things in your control and it's always God given, I think it was important that we wait for our parents who we bought, not only with the weather, but the chaotic traffic around town. And we've tried to wait as long as we can, but there's always a time to start. So before we begin, we'll just bow and we'll pray. Lord, give you thanks and praise, Lord, for this wonderful evening that you brought us all together. We thank you for the opportunity that you give to us here in bishops for yet another production. Lord, we ask for thy blessings to be bestowed upon all those who have worked so hard during the course of the last few weeks, for the teachers, for the ones who trained the choir, for the dancers, for our cast, for our crew backstage, for Mr. John and his team, the sounds and light. And we also, Lord, thank you for our parents who have been so cooperative in bringing our children for the various rehearsals. Lord, as we go into this evening's program, we ask that you lead us. You take care of this entire function, and you ensure that whatever we do, Lord, we do it for thy greater glory. This we ask in thy precious name. Amen. We'd like to thank all our parents for being with us this evening, for our heads, a warm welcome to Mrs. Lily White and the Commander Wilson. We also have a special guest, Mr. Graham Hayden, the Vice Principal of Christ Church, Mumbai. Thank you, sir, for being with us. My colleagues, Mr. McPherson and Mr. Luke, are heads from our sister schools. Some die-hard Bishopites, which they call themselves 24/7. Thank you for being here, and all our friends. Arnav Bansal, head boy of the senior school, will introduce the play to us. If there is a seat which is vacant at the side of you, please do make an indication to our ushers, our junior college children, because there will be parents who will be joining us in due course of time, because I think they've been caught up in traffic. But we will make it possible for all of them to be seated with us as soon that they come into this hall. So without further ado, I hand over to Arnav Bansal.
Good evening to one and all present here. The play that we're about to stage is entitled Mamma Mia, the Musical Extravaganza. Here's a synopsis of what you're about to witness. As Sophie and her family are preparing for a wedding, she secretly invites seven men to her wedding, who were her mother Donna's acquaintances in her youth. On their arrival, Sophie is unable to identify who her real father is, and her mother Donna is extremely horrified on seeing them all in a hotel a day prior to Sophie's wedding. There is complete chaos and perplexity as things unfold in an unforeseen and exhilarating manner. So sit back and enjoy as the Bishop School Camp and Junior College proudly presents Mamma Mia, the Musical Extravaganza.
Thank you. I'm getting married tomorrow. And I'm so glad you're here. Because I have a secret. And I can't tell anybody else.
Sophie, don't tell me you did something your mom told you not to do.
No. I've invited my dad to the wedding.
What? You are joking. You found him at last.
No. Not exactly. Okay, so you know what my mom always said when I asked about my father, right? It was a summer romance and things didn't quite work out well for them. And I'd always kind of accepted that. In fact, that's all I'd ever known. Well, I was ransacking some old trunks and I found this. It's the diary she kept the year she was married to my dad. Unfortunately, she destroyed all evidence of him and left me with just this.
Oh, Sophie!
July 17th. What a night.
I don't think I want to hear this.
I do.
Sam rowed me over to the little island that's here at Scalocheri. We danced on the beach and ...
What?
... That's what they did in the olden days.
Oh, stop it!
Sam's the one. I know he is. I've never felt like this before. Going to see him again.
Poor Donna.
August 4th. What a night. Bill rented a motorboat and I took him over to the little island. Though I'm still obsessed with Sam. Bill's so wild. He's such a funny guy. One thing led to another and...
...
August 11th. Harry turned up out of the blue. So I said I'd show him the island. He's so sweet and understanding.
I couldn't help it, Anne.
Don't! Oh my God! September 16th, Carlos, Ronnie, Don, and Tom visited the island for a camp. We had a splendid time, and then...
And then
what? I don't know, the page is torn.
So who is your man?
Sam. Phil?
block area. Because there's always a lot of hustle and bustle around that place. So maybe, just maybe, news will spread and they'll all be here.
You are so
cool. I want the perfect wedding. And I want my father to give me away.
You are going to look fabulous tomorrow. But with 7 fathers, it better be a white eye.
I will know my father as soon as I see him.
Calicary. When's the next ferry?
Day after.
What?
Monday.
Goodness gracious.
Yeah, my sentiments exactly. Are you off to the wedding? Bride or groom?
Bride. Although I've actually never met her.
Hi there. You guys need a ride to Calicary?
I know who you are. You're Bill Anderson, aren't you? A bloke in a boat in Botswana.
Yes, I am.
You know, your books are a godsend on dull business trips. Now, I may look like I'm pondering my securities, but in reality, I'm across some remote corner of the planet.
Well, you should try it for real sometime.
No. Sadly, I'll never be the spontaneous adventurer.
Are you a close friend of Dollars?
No, I haven't heard from her for 20 years.
Really?
And then that album flashed all over the place. How does it look?
You know, that's a coincidence. Well, neither had I.
Needs a purse. want her to.
Well, what was better for her?
Of course not. Sky!
Come meet my backup girl.
Backup girl? What nonsense!
He's the leading man at tomorrow's shindig.
The lucky
man. Well, hello.
How are you?
Fabulous, thank you.
You must be tired.
Uh-huh.
I've heard so much about you.
Oh, God, I heard. And all true.
Laura, would you like me to show them around the island?
Hands tied, that would be fantastic.
Sophie Sheridan, you get more and more gorgeous Sure, we're here for the wedding. I'm Bill Anderson.
Bill Anderson?
I'm Bright. Harry Bright.
Harry! So you must be...
Sam Carmichael.
That's Don, Carlos, Ronnie, and myself, Tom. We had an amazing time right here during a camp, a lifetime away.
You are expecting us?
Oh my God, yes.
You're not Donna's daughter, are you?
I thought you looked familiar. Sophia?
It's Sophie.
Oh, well, Sophia is the Greek.
Well, I'm named after Sophia.
I used to have a great aunt living on the mainland named Sophia.
Would you mind if we see our rooms before we see your mother?
Sure.
It's just that I'd quite like to freshen up before the big reunion.
No! No, I mean, yes. But come this way.
But okay.
make an entrance.
I'd better be dreaming. You'd better not be here.
You want me to pinch you, Donna?
What? No! Keep your hands to yourself, Bill Anderson.
You probably don't recognize me, do you?
Harry, it is you.
I've probably changed a bit, but you certainly haven't.
Hmm? Okay, why are you here?
I'm writing a travel piece.
I'm here on a spontaneous holiday.
I just dropped in to say hi.
What? You all are here too?
Yeah, we just decided to read about the road camping countries.
Okay, what is this?
It's one of those rare fitness moments in life where a couple of strangers share one thought.
Strangers? You all don't know each other?
That's generally the definition, Donna.
Okay, but who's saying if it's here at my old boat house?
Big Catherine. Greek lady, I think she was.
Well, she spoke Greek.
Or maybe she said Greek. Could it stay at our boat house?
Yeah, maybe that was it. In Greek.
Yes, that's it. That's it. You can't stay here. Because I'm close, and I'm full, and I'm busy. There's a wedding. My uncle's girl's getting married.
Donna, I'm doing funny about us. Billy is easy roughing it out.
And spontaneous.
Spontaneous.
What about you?
I just wanted to visit the island. No one mentioned me.
Okay, I'm gonna arrange for a boat to take all of you back to the mainland.
I have a boat, Donna.
You have a boat? Good. Then get on it. And stay away. Away, away!
Hey, Donna.
It's good to see you.
Donna, Donna,
don't you
see him and the others in the old boathouse the day before my daughter's wedding.
The old boathouse?
Wait, no, Ruthie. Don't let that go, you.
But there's nobody here.
Are you sure? What? Of course I'm sure. You think I forget my daughter's dance? They were all here. Sam Carmichael, Bill Anderson, Harry the Headbanger.
Bill Anderson? What a hunk.
Not Harry the Headbanger. They must have gone back to the boat. I hope they run aground and drown. Like some hideous trick of fate.
Do they know about Sophie?
What? Of course not. Never told us gold.
Oh, Donna. Keeping it to yourself all these years?
It doesn't matter. It doesn't matter about me. What matters is that Sophie should never find out. Tear her heart apart.
But maybe she could be cool with it.
Cool with it? You don't know my daughter. This would be like a bombshell.
Donna, relax. They're gone.
I don't know that. I don't know why they're gone.
Oh, it's Catherine Gill, darling. You've been living like a nun.
Yeah.
Whatever happened to her, Donna? The lightning storm of the party.
Rock checks and bring
I grew up.
Well, then go back.
but Mother, he rejected us from the boathouse.
We thought we'd better get out of her head.
So now freaked out when she saw us. What was that about?
No, she's not even thinking straight. She's so stressed about the wedding. But she's got no idea that you're her lovely surprise. She'll be so happy tomorrow.
You think so?
You don't want it up.
No, I bought it, look. Where is it? D.S. Donna Sheldon. An HP. Headbanger.
Headbanger?
I bought her this. It cost me 10 quid plus my Johnny Rotten t-shirt. Your mother knew quieter than her. I was studying in Paris when I met her. I hopped on a train and followed her to Greece. Quite spontaneously. Here you go.
I can still recall our last summer. I still see it all. Walked along the same unfamiliar way. Our last summer memory that remains. We made our way along the river and we sat down in the grass by the apple tower. Of no regret. Oh yes. But 20 years of the time of the flower power. But underneath we had a fear of flying, of growing old, of fear slowly dying. We could chant like we were dancing our last time. Walking hand in hand, Paris restaurant, our
You guys remember when we snuck into that orchard for a picnic?
Yes.
We were lying right in the tree.
Oh, the branch broken on our bed. All boats fail. I caught her. What a match the moment it was. I felt like a hero, man.
Wow, I can't believe it's been 20 years since we last met her.
Oh, yes, I remember the days I swam out there like a dolphin.
Cut it out, buddy. You were a walrus back then.
This is talking about a few. If Sophie's dictator were man, we all have to do that for sober. Now we all know why you're here. Pretend to be Sophie. Just bought a beautiful piece of property in Jardin.
Oh, that's so mean of you.
Just shut up. Don't be such a fool. I say I'm desiring forever. If I just have Sophie, then I am her dad. Ha ha ha!
Ready?
Let's
don't have plenty.
How long have you known him? I'm your father.
What? Not long at all. Sam, listen to me. My mom doesn't know that I know, so can you wait until after my wedding?
Who's taking your photo?
Nobody.
Wrong. I am. Oh, that's a secret to them.
Oh.
For you, but you have closed your mind. Whatever happened to our love, I wish I understood. It used to be so nice, it used to be so good.
Thank you. wonderful production. I think we can put our hands together for this wonderful band that we have on the stage. Thank you, children. You come back. And we made the center proud, we made us proud as a school. Before we go into the appreciation of all those who have worked so hard over the weeks, and we'd like to felicitate them. We always put this lady on the spot to say a few things. I think she pays the price for attending our functions from Mumbai. So we'll request our governing body member, Mrs. Lillibat, to say a few words.
This was unprecedented. I thought I was getting away this time because he didn't say anything earlier. Ladies and gentlemen, first our governing body member, Wing Commander Wilson, members of the staff, senior members of the school, and all the supervisors, coordinators, whatever. But most of all, to each one of you parents and to the crew and the actors. Each one of you is an actor in your own right. Where do I start? Because somehow or the other I seem to be repeating myself, but I have no options. Each time there's a new crowd here, and I'd like to tell you that I feel so proud when I come to these events. I must tell you, I arrived at 12:45 this morning because I was caught in a traffic jam, but it's been something really worthwhile watching Mamma Mia. I must tell you that I forced the vice principal of Christchurch School, because he's an actor, a singer, a dancer, and what have you. And I told him, you've just got to come with me to Bishop's, and you've got to witness their concerts. Friends, the children taking part here are exemplary. I mean, you don't see this standard in many schools, and you've got to be proud that your children are different again. In most schools, I would say this would take days, months, years maybe to come to this standard. But I know that Bishop's is so full of activities that I wouldn't be right wrong when saying if they were 2-3 weeks into acting, practicing? A little more? Okay, a month. A month, and this kind of production is unprecedented, because I've done plays myself, I've conducted senior school plays and musicals, and it's been a tough ball. As I was just telling him, and we were chatting about the standard.
Every one of them seems to be a singer in their own right. Every one of them seems to have emotions that they bring out. Every one of them is doing his
or her part to their fullest and to their best ability. And this does not come naturally. And I want you parents to realize that this is more important than those books. This is where character formation takes place. Children, you have been amazing. You have really been amazing. Year after year, when I've been seeing your concerts and I hear your singing, I just are in raptures. I don't know really what to say. But each one of you, I'm not picking out any one of you, but I think each one of you, even the smallest part that you've had today, you've played it with excellence.
Far excellence.
Congratulations to each one. Congratulations to the staff, to Mr. Edwin, Mr. Gaynor, and all those involved, the music department, sound and lights. And as I was just telling Graham, that the sound, the lights have been controlled by the class service staff, or I don't know what you call them, their pews. He could not believe it. Class 4 staff controlling the lights. It was amazing, because Graham mentioned, I can see that the sounds go off. See, when you've done this, you notice that mics are being switched off and switched on. They know when to switch on and when to switch off. It's amazing. Congratulations to each one of you. There's nothing more I can say, but except that You have been marvelous. Congratulations.
We call our headmasters, later to get all those who've been part of this wonderful production, the efforts that have been over the past few weeks, and we will be felicitated for them. Thank you, sir. Ladies and gentlemen, you know our students are very good at acting in class, and you know now you know how to be on stage. So I think once again, put your hands together for all our wonderful actors and the choir. I'd like to begin by requesting Wing Commander Wilson to kindly help out in felicitating the people who had a major role or hand in making this play a success this evening. A big thank you to all parents for allowing your awards to be a part of this production and making it a big success, because it's been days of hard work behind the scenes, besides being available during the holidays. When most of us were at home relaxing, these kids were practicing. And believe me, there was a lot of tears and also a lot of laughter and cheer. Finally, this is what we have. We wanted to kindly help out in giving out the awards to concerned people. I'd like our principal to kindly escort our board member. We begin. We'd like to thank Mrs. Manju Singhal of Arunda Creations for the wonderful costuming you see here, ladies and gentlemen. I'll move on. I think she's not going to leave him. For the lovely PowerPoint presentation and the LED presentation prepared by Mr. Fakre. All the appetizing and scrumptious food we have every day for the cast and crew. Mr. Joshi, if you're around. I think she's preparing something for us after the program. For the hairstyling and makeup, Mrs. A. Chatterjee. Oh, Mr. Joshi's on his way. Thank you, sir. Mrs. Chatterjee. Mrs. M. Shik. Mrs. S. Piradiga. Mrs. P. Agrawal. Mrs. S. Chaudhary. And Mrs. P. Siddiqui. Taken during the practices. A big thank you to our photography club members. The team was spearheaded by Prisha Dutani and Om Patel. And for all the hard work getting the props on and off stage, a big thank you to our stage crew led by Vinay Chandani. I'd now like to request our board member, Mrs. Blossom Lillywhite, to kindly help us the next round of awards. Ladies and gentlemen, you see that lovely set behind? That was constructed by our carpenters, Mr. Dubey and Mr. Chaptar.
wonderful lighting and the amplification. We'd like to thank Mr. Manoj, Mr. Subhash, and Samir. Principal to kindly stay back. Now these honors are given to people in a special role behind the scenes in making this evening a success. The script writer and director of the play, Mrs. Gulnar Mistry. Sound, we have Mr. L. John Stank. Now we have something sweet to appreciate our dancers, members of the dancing crew. Come forward, please. Thank you. And not forgetting the ones who stole the show, the actors. We would like to also felicitate our governing body members, Wing Commander Wilson, and Mrs. Russell Weaver. And ladies and gentlemen, we are so busy thanking everyone else. But the person behind the scenes in the rain today, helping give this place in one piece that the kids wouldn't get wet in the rain and they make a good kids' boy. I want to know the principal, Mr. Joe Lennon. Thank you, sir. And the president, Mr. Crossman, the congratulations.
Since we've had the special guest with us, and we would like a few words from him. I know it will take a few more minutes, and if you can bear with us, we'll have Mr. Graham Lennon to just address us. Since he's been to Bishops for the first time for our functions, he's been a friend of ours for a long time, but for the first time, he's also been asked to be here today.
Thank you, Mr.
Lennon.
Thank you, Mr. Lennon. Members of the governing body, the principal, Mr. Edwin, principal of the two mission schools, Mr. Luke and Mr. McPherson, and parents present here this evening, and this wonderful cast on stage. I think in their lingo, we can just sum it up in one word. It was wow, wow, wow. It was a stellar performance by most of the actors on stage. I think the precision was fantastic. The lights going off at the right time, the sound coming on at the right time. The acting was as natural as you can get it. It was not acting, it was just you being there on stage and giving off your best from the heart. And that's what acting is all about. The singing, the voices were fantastic. You just sang to the T. You sounded like ABBA. The words, the voice of the solos, amazing. It was very, very wonderful. And I just want to say to all of you that school life, the memories of school life is made up of this. So I think Bishop School has really fulfilled the words of the singer Whitney Houston, when she said in that beautiful song, "I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be." So in conclusion, I just want to say to the cast on stage, Mamma Mia, the winner takes it all. I think, ladies and gentlemen, they deserve
more than just that applause. Please leave your seats. They need
a standing ovation. Congratulations, and God bless each one of you.
Request for all on stage to please stand for the national anthem.
Yeah.
Those parents who like to collect the children would please move down to the basement, and in about 5 minutes after they share the cakes that they've got, they will be meeting you in the basement. And thank you once again for being here. We hope you enjoyed this evening with us, and we hope to see you for our next session. Thank you everyone.